Granny's, Abner. I believe that's our ring.
I dog as Lum, I believe you're right.
I'll see. Hello, jot 'em down, store. This is Lum and Abner.
Let's see what's going on down at Pine Ridge. Well, Assistant Dr. Edwards and Assistant's Assistant Dr. Peabody are fast whipping the store into shape to serve as a reception room or Dr. Samuel W. Snide's dental office in the feed room. As we look in on the little community today, we find the old fellows in their jot 'em down store and library. Abner is commenting on Lum's latest innovation.
Oh, Lum, I don't want to wear this outfit. I feel downright silly.
Abner, if we're going to be assistant dentists, we got to look like assistant dentists.
Yeah, but we look like a couple of house painters with these things on, Lum.
No, we don't. We look good in these white coats. Look official and doctorish. Look sort of medicated.
Well, what are folks going to say when they read that printing on the back of the coat, though? You reeky paint and varnish.
Nobody needs to see the back of our coat.
Huh?
Just don't turn your back whenever a patient comes in the store. That's simple enough.
Yeah, if somebody does come in here, I'll feel like turning my back and hiding my face.
Abner, that ain't the right altitude to take. You don't have proper respect for the dental profession.
I don't, huh?
Of course not.
Well, let's switch coats in, Lum. This one here is a heap too big for me. Maybe if I had one that fit me, well, I might have a different altitude.
They're both the same size. That's all I could get.
Oh.
When you go home for supper tonight, you can have Elizabeth take it in a little bit at the side there. Better have her shorten it, too, and cut them sleeves off. Granny, you can't even see your hands there.
I know it.
We've got no freak here in the store.
I know it. Looked down there a while ago and scared myself to death. Thought I'd lost them for a minute. I believe it ought to be shorter, though. It ought to be at least a little above the knees, oughtn't it?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And here's another thing. You might take some lamp black and darken up your beard a little.
Darken up my beard?
Yeah, we ought to have a pointed black beard, sort of.
Huh?
Van Dyke's. Then we'd really look like high-class doctors.
Huh?
I'm going to start to let my beard grow, I think.
Well, I ain't going to do it, Mom. Everybody in town would know what I was coloring my beard, and I'd be the laughing stocks. That's what I'd be.
Now, listen, Abner, you want to be the assistant dentist's assistant, don't you?
Why, sure, Lum.
All right, then. Black up your beard.
I dog is Lum now.
Nobody will ever mistake you for a house painter if you have a nice, pointed black beard, will it?
Well, no, I reckon
all
not.
Right. That solves all your problems for you, then, right there.
Of course, they're liable to mistake me for an idiot, though. And it won't be no mistake, neither. They'll be right.
No, they'll be partly wrong. You're not plumb crazy, I don't think.
Huh?
You've got some sense.
Oh, you're just saying that so I'll color my beard. That's all you're doing it for. I know you. I don't see what we have to do all this for anyway, Lum. First, we put up a piece of garden hose and holler, calling Dr. Edwards through the thing, and now we got to wear a black beard.
I told you once, Abner, that I promised Dr. Snide I'd help him build up a big practice here.
I know it.
Told him I'd build his dentist business up to where he'd be making $800 or $900 a year.
Well, I don't see how us wearing painter's coats is going to help him do that, Lum.
Well, in the first place, they ain't painter's coats. They're dentist coats now. In the second place, it's psychology.
Huh?
Just plain, common, everyday bay horse business psychology. That's all it is.
Is that what it is?
Why, sure. You just wait and watch the next customer that comes in the store here.
Watch him.
As soon as you call Dr. Edwards on the lounge speaking gadget there and he sees us in our white coats, I bound you he'll want to have some dental work done right here and now.
He will, huh?
Oh, yeah. Not only that, he'd be willing to pay a high price for it, too. That's the way it always works.
Well, I'll have to see it before I believe anything like that. You know good and well that nobody actually wants to have any tooth work done on them, Lum.
No, of course not. But if they do need some dentistry, they want to get it done in a high-class way. That gives them confidence and all that.
And all I can say is I've got to see it first.
Yeah, don't worry. You'll see it. Just wait.
I'll wait.
Dr. Snide don't know how lucky he is he decided to locate here. I got a lot more ideas that's going to help him, too.
You have, huh?
Oh, yeah. I might even revolutionize the whole dental industry someday. I don't know. Here's one idea I got. I'm going to have Dr. Snide run a contest every month.
Contest?
Yes, sir. Give a prize to the person that has the biggest tooth pulled each month.
Well, Winifred Redfield would win that hands down every month then, Lum. That wouldn't be no contest. Well, that is, unless, of course, that horse that Doc Snide was working on today would enter it.
No, we wouldn't let no horses get in the contest.
Well, Doc more than likely's got that horse's teeth filed down to where they'd just win second prize anyway. Winifred would win first every time.
Well, she ain't going to have a tooth pulled every month this year.
If old Charlie Redfield thought she'd win something that way she would, he'd see to that. No, that ain't much good, Lum, that idea, no, sir.
Well, I got a whole lot more ideas even better than that.
You have, huh?
Now, for instance, you know that Dr. Snide specializes in making false teeth.
Yeah, I know that. He made that set he wears himself, he said.
Well, I got an idea how to help him sell them plates he makes a lot faster.
Get out some handbills?
No, he's already got a batch of them out. And he's got some good ones, too. I think I got one right here in my pocket.
Well, I never know what he had.
I got it over at the blacksmith shop a while ago.
Well, let me see it. You got it there?
Yeah,
let me
here.
Look at that. Huh. Dr. Snide's lifelike plates. Can't tell them from the real thing.
Uh-huh.
Look, there's a picture of old Doc there smiling, showing his teeth.
He don't look much like him, though, does
he? Oh, look, underneath there says, Dr. Snide's teeth. True or false?
Yeah, I studied that idea up myself.
He did, huh?
Yeah, but he's got one better than that, too.
Huh?
Well, look down there at the bottom.
Oh.
Slogan.
Once you've tried Dr. Snide's no slip, no slide dental plates, you'll never go back to your old teeth. That's a gooder.
Gooder.
Well, if your idea ain't to get out more handbills, what is it, Lum?
Well, I'm going to have Doc make up a whole big batch of plates and then put on a big sale.
Sale?
Yeah. Tooth sale.
Huh?
Three sets of teeth for half price or something like that.
Three sets? Why, Lord me, Lum, nobody ain't going to need but one set of plates. That is, unless they got two heads.
No, we won't need to depend on two-headed fellers for our business. You just wait till you hear the rest of my ideas.
Go ahead.
We're going to make everybody in this whole country extra set conscious.
Huh?
We're going to make folks realize that they ought to have several sets of teeth.
Oh.
For instance, they ought to have a spare set in case they lose their regular one.
Well, now, that's a pretty good idea. Grandma Masters is always having to help Grandpa find his teeth before breakfast. Happens might now every morning.
Yeah, and then I figured they ought to have a special steak set.
Steak set?
Yeah, some with extra sharp teeth in them for eating beefsteaks.
Well, law me, Lum, they wouldn't need them very often nowadays, not with all them ration points on beefsteak now.
No, but when they do get it, they need to chew it more than they used to. I know that.
Yeah.
Then they can use the sharp set for eating raw carrots and stuff like that.
Anybody living over at the boarding house there could use them on them biscuits that Sister Simpson makes. There's the hardest one batch of victual that any human ever had to set a tooth in.
Yeah, hand grenades, they call them over there.
Recollect old Elmer Hopkins that used to board over there. He claimed that that's how he broke all his front teeth off, swore up and down. It was true. That's what done it.
Yeah, good. And then there's that story Tom Foster tells. Said one day a boarder throwed a batch of them biscuits out of the window and they landed in a flower bed. And the next day, Sister Simpson won a ribbon for having the prettiest rock garden in the county.
I've heard him tell that 1,000 or 100 times.
He's comical, that Tommy.
Say, I know another kind of teeth we could have, Lum, a special set for eating corn on the cob.
Grannies, I believe you got something there.
Good wide teeth with no spaces in between them. Never miss a kernel with them. No.
You know, I might get Dr. Snide to name that set after you.
Huh?
Dr. Peabody's Corn Teeth or something like that.
Doggies, that sounds good. Dr. Peabody's Corn Teeth. Hooray for me.
And then we can make up a special set for... Oh, wait a minute. There comes Ulysses.
Huh?
Hi, Granny Sabner. You just watch now. I bound you when he sees our white coats and everything, we'll be able to talk him into having some dental work done.
I bet we won't. Not Ulysses. He won't spend no money if he can keep from it long. Besides, Dr. Snide ain't here now.
I know, but we can make an appointment for you, Lacey.
Oh, yeah.
Don't forget to act dignified and medicated and all that. Call me on the loudspeaker once in a while.
Well, all right. Yeah. Well, howdy, Ulysses. Come on in.
Yeah, how are you today, Ulysses?
Okay, Lum, okay.
Now, sir, what can we do for you today, sir?
Well, ask one. What are you fellas wearing them outfits for?
Oh, we have to wear them. We're in business now.
Yeah, Lum's assistant, and I'm assistant. Just call me Doc. That's all right.
That's right, Ulysses. We're bona fide assistants.
Well, sir, I'm glad you're taking this work up, because I've got some work, and I need to get done right away.
Well, good. Now, we can fix you an appointment for, say, tomorrow morning at 10 o'clock.
Well, I'd like to get this started today, Lum. I hate to put it off any longer.
But Dr. Snide ain't here now, though.
Well, I'd rather you fellas would do it anyway. Maybe you'd do a better job than he would. I have confidence in you two.
Well, that's nice.
And I'm willing to pay you $25 for the work, too.
Did you say $25?
For the land sales.
Ulysses, you wait right there. Calling Dr. Peabody. Dr. Peabody wanted in conference with Dr. Eddards.
Ha.
Step back here a second, Abner.
Oh.
We'll be right back, Ulysses.
Yeah, okay.
Hurry up, Abner.
I'm coming. What is it? What's the matter?
Granny's, I told you'd work out this way, didn't I?
You sure surprised me. $25, he said.
And I think we better do the work for him, too.
Us? Why, we can't do that, Lord.
Well, if it's just pulling a tooth, we ought to be able to do that. Just take the doc's pliers back there and pull. Or we could tie a string around to it and tie the other end to the doorknob and slam the door.
I'll go out that door fast enough to pull his head off or two out one.
We can't pass up that $25. Doc needs the money.
Yeah, if you think more, too, I'm for it.
Good. Conference over. Oh, come on. All right, Ulysses. It's a deal. We'll do the work.
Well, good. I'm glad to get this settled.
Now, if you just step back here in the feed room and sit down in the dentist chair.
Do I have to sit there long?
Why, sure. That's where we do the dentistry work.
Dentistry work? I don't want no dentistry work done. I seen you fellas with them painter's coats on. I was offering you $25 to paint my barn for me.